Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. In today's video I am going to be doing a do's and don'ts video for drawing realistic fur, and for this tutorial I am actually using graphite pencils and talking about some of the mistakes people make when drawing fur and how to avoid those mistakes. So I am starting with the don't side first, and I'm just picking out the most common mistakes I see beginners make. And as I said, this video is to help break down how to draw realistic fur and just how to improve techniques. So firstly, one of the most common things I see a lot of beginners doing is drawing fur in mainly one shade of pencil. So for this version, the don'ts version, I'm only using a 6B pencil for this section of fur. Now the trouble is, when using just one pencil to draw with, you aren't giving yourself a wide range of shades, and shades are really important because you want to be able to build up on those light, medium and dark tones. So if you are just using one pencil, it's going to be really hard for you to do that. Also, as I said before, I am using a 6B pencil, and that leads me nicely on to the next mistake a lot of people make, and that is that they just often go in with a very dark pencil. Sometimes they do go in with a very light pencil, so in that respect they don't get correct pencil values either. And pencil values and shades are really important when you're drawing fur. You want the fur to look realistic, and by adding in shading, shadows and light and dark areas, you're going to get that realistic look. But I'm not doing that for this drawing, so it does look really scruffy and unnatural straight away. So I'm going in way too dark with the 6B pencil and just applying a very heavy hand, which is something that I see quite a lot of beginners doing. And this means that I'm not building up layers, so I'm not starting with light layers and building up to those dark values. Straight away I'm applying so much pressure to the paper. With a 6B pencil as well, this is not very good because 6B pencils are a lot darker than the H pencils. So that means that you're going to get a much darker result. Plus the B pencils, particularly 6B all the way up to 9B, will give you a lot of shine in your drawing. The next point I wanted to make, and I see this a lot, is that artists use their fingers quite often to blend out graphite pencils, and this is definitely something that you're going to want to avoid doing. Your fingers have a lot of oil in them, so if you use your fingers to blend graphite out, you could smear all of those oils onto the paper, and that could really ruin your piece. The oils in your fingers could create splotches or even discolour your drawings, so for the do version I will show you a really effective and simple way to blend out those pencils in a much better way. One of the last points I wanted to make for the don'ts version about drawing fur really relates to your hand position and again pencil pressure. So I notice a lot of beginners use a really hard pressure on the pencil to try and darken an area, and to do that they hold their pencil at the very tip of the pencil and push really hard down onto the paper. So by doing this you're going to get areas with really concentrated pigment, plus you could risk damaging the tooth of your paper. I'm also showing on the screen how holding your pencil too loosely is not a good idea either. It's not an effective way for drawing fur, as it's really hard to get pencil control. So make sure that you are holding your pencil comfortably and effectively. Okay, so now I am moving on to the do version, and hopefully these tips will help you if you do struggle a little bit with drawing realistic fur. Don't worry if you are using any of these techniques I have mentioned for the don'ts version, because you can easily refine those techniques to get even better results. Okay, so the first thing that is really important for drawing realistic fur is by starting off your drawing really light. So here I am using both a 2H pencil, which is a very light graphite pencil, and I'm also using a B pencil, which is still quite a hard lead. And I'm starting off with those pencils to make sure that I build up on my layers of fur gradually and very lightly. It is really hard to get in lighter areas if you start off really dark, so you want to make sure that you start off nice and light so that you can build on your values gradually and all of your layers. So I'm using the 2H pencil, and notice how I'm holding that pencil. As I said, hand position is really important here to get the right techniques. So by holding the pencil halfway down the pencil, it enables me to get an even distribution of pencil pressure, so not too hard and not too soft. I'm also working much slower with building up the fur. I'm taking my time to really focus on drawing the fur realistically, and for this side, I'm not just drawing fur wherever I feel like it or trying to draw it from from memory, I am actually using a reference photo. So it is really important to use a reference photo for any drawing you are doing. Reference photos give you a visual, and you can really take your time to study everything within that reference photo, including all the little details. Also, another quick tip for using reference photos, if you are doing graphite drawings, make sure that your reference photos are in grayscale and not in color, as that will really help you to understand your values and shades more. So going back to that drawing, I've used the 2H pencil to just gently shade in some of the fur details, so paying particular attention to the direction of fur and type of fur, and now I'm going to softly blend out some of the pencil so that it helps build up some mid-tones. I am using a cotton bud for this technique, so I'm not using my fingers. Remember I said that your fingers have oils in them, whereas cotton buds don't, and they are great for blending out graphite pencils, especially small details due to the small bud. I'm also trying to avoid working in sweeping motions. For the don'ts version, I used a lot of back and forth motions to draw and blend out the fur, and for the do version, I'm working softly and mainly in one direction, or sometimes in circular motions. Now, I like to blend out the pencils in between layers for two main reasons. Firstly, when you blend out graphite, you add more value down, and we want to concentrate a lot of our values and mid-tones for this drawing. So we want light, mid, and dark tones, and blending out graphite acts as our mid-tones. So that is going to help us add depth to our drawing. The second reason I blend out graphite pencils when drawing fur is because it aids with the layering process. So now what I am doing is starting to add darker values by going in with a 3B pencil. So I'm using the 3B pencil in the areas where I want to hype up those dark values. I'm looking at my reference photo every few seconds to see where those dark values are as well. And then I am gently shading in those darker areas by holding my pencil nearer the tip and etching in those fur strokes. But I'm making sure that I don't apply too much pencil pressure, just enough to intensify the dark values. So I am starting to draw in some of those darker areas, but I will be making sure that all the fur blends in together smoothly and naturally. With the don'ts version, I didn't do that. I just concentrated those dark values in one area and I didn't work some lighter tones into the fur. So I'm really taking my time here to make sure that I am rendering the fur as naturally and realistically as possible. And that is definitely the biggest tip that I can give you for drawing realistically. Time really is crucial. You need to be very patient and build up your layers gradually and take the time to do that. For the don'ts version, I didn't allow myself any time to study the fur and draw the fur properly, so we didn't get a good result. But with this side, I'm taking a lot more time to build up on that process. So the don'ts version took me around 5 to 7 minutes to do in total, but for the do version, that actually took me over an hour to do, and it really shows because already we are getting a much more realistic look. So another thing that you should do is make sure that you leave some areas free of graphite or with little graphite on as well, because you do want to preserve some highlights. So notice how on the do version I have actually left some areas quite light. Those areas are light because of the initial layers I added to the paper, and I've purposely avoided adding any more pencil values down to those areas because they are my lightest areas. So later on, I'm going to intensify those areas even more by using an eraser to bring the fur even further forward. Okay, so now I'm going in with a 6B pencil and I'm now going to start adding in some much darker value down. So it's taken me a lot of time to build up on this shade of pencil because it is so dark. Whereas with the don'ts version, I went in with a 6B pencil straight away, so I didn't build up my layers gradually. By going in with a dark pencil much later on, it's allowed me to build up my layers, build up the different tones, and also when I hold up my drawing to the light, it looks a lot better. It doesn't have that shine that the don'ts version did. Okay, so I am now moving on to the highlights, and honestly, this is probably my favourite part of a drawing, and especially with drawing fur and graphite. I just love building up my layers and tones and then going in with my highlights. I am using the Tombow Mono Eraser, which is like an eraser pen, and this eraser is incredible as it's quite pointy and small, so it's going to be able to lift really small details such as fur strands. I would also recommend using a kneaded eraser. So if you don't have the Tombow Mono eraser, a kneaded eraser will work just as well, as a kneaded eraser can be molded into shape. So you can mold it into a point and lift up some of that graphite. Kneaded erasers are also really soft and gentle, and they don't smear pencil, whereas sometimes some other erasers can do that. So either of those erasers are good options for using. Now, when I use this eraser, I'm using it quite softly in stroking motions. So I'm gently stroking the paper with the eraser, and straight away it's lifting up some of that graphite pencil and creating much lighter layers. I'm also making sure that I do go over some of the darker areas too. This is because if we just lifted up graphite pencils in one area, that area will look really light and then another area will look really dark. So that is going to look really out of place. I also like to go back in with my pencils after I have erased an area, and this is just to get rid of any obvious white lines or eraser marks and just to add some value back in where it might have been lost. And I'll also do this process a few times, so maybe two or three times, where I go in with the eraser, lift up some of that pencil, go back in with some more graphite, and then I use the eraser again until I feel that the fur is looking exactly how I want it to look. So it is really important to remember that with fur, everything is really subtle. There may be darker fur or different coloured fur in the animal, so for example with a tiger that has ginger fur and black stripes, all the fur does actually transition softly into each other, and you will see this if you study a reference photo up close. So make sure that when you do something to one area, for example erasing an area to create highlights, that you do drag some of those highlighted areas into the darker areas as well, just to make it look like it is going from lighter to darker fur. One last thing I also wanted to mention as a final tip for drawing fur is to try and focus on getting in some flyaway hairs at the end. So after I have rendered an area, to add even more realism to a piece, I do like to add in some flyaway hairs. And to do that, I will use a sharp pencil, in this case graphite pencil, and just use flicking motions to add in some fur strands. And this does look quite realistic. I also do have a brand new Patreon tutorial on how to draw fur in graphite pencils coming out very, very soon, and I'll have more information on that video very soon for you. And anyway guys, that just about finishes off today's video, and as always I really hope that you enjoyed this one, and I will definitely look forward to seeing you all in my next video.